Hi, this is JB from Northerlands over Arkham. This time I will be looking at the solo player's buyer's guide for Marvel Champions the card game. I decided to make this buyer's guide for mainly solo players because there starts to be a lot of product for Marvel Champions, and I have received a few inquiries from new players that are asking which product they should buy first. So let's get started. The first thing you of course need to buy is the base game for Marvel Champions the card game. The base game comes with 5 heroes you can play. There are Captain Marvel, Spider-Man, Iron Man, She-Hulk, and Black Panther. There are also 3 scenarios you can play. The tutorial scenario Rhino is a basic scenario that you learn the game mechanics with, but also you can ramp it up by playing it on expert and testing decks. So it's a good starting tutorial, but nothing special. Then there is Claw. Claw is the medium difficulty scenario in the core set. It is not that difficult on standard difficulty, but later when you are experiencing the expert mode, Claw is a good scenario to test out decks and offers a decent amount of challenge. The main villain in the core box is Ultron, and Ultron offers a lot of challenge for players with only the core set. So after you beat Ultron on standard, you may be having a lot of trouble first beating him on expert mode. And to remind new players, there are a few modular sets in the core set, so you can ramp up and change the scenarios a bit with those, so you can make some scenarios a lot more difficult, or just make them play out a bit different with the different modular sets that you implement into the counter deck. The second product I would buy as a new player, if I would be playing true solo, is the Rise of Red Skull campaign expansion. Rise of Red Skull offers 2 new heroes to play. You get Hawkeye and Spider-Woman in the box. And there are also 5 new scenarios to play. The main problem Marvel Champions had at the start of the game's lifespan, it was that there were plenty of heroes to play, but not that many scenarios to play against. The Rise of Red Skull box offers a good set of villains to play against and a couple of new heroes, so I would definitely buy that next. After the Rise of Red Skull, I would start buying some of the hero packs that have been released already. Captain America is maybe the first you should buy. Captain America is an all-around hero that can play well against any scenario on his own. He comes with the leadership aspect cards. So if you like leadership, you should also buy Captain America first. My personal favorite hero so far is Black Widow. Black Widow comes with the justice aspect and can play well with other aspects also. But justice is a good true solo player aspect, as you can keep the villain's main scheme threat low, so you don't lose the game by threatening out that easily. So as Black Widow comes with justice, I would buy her hero pack quite early, so you have a decent hero that can play well against all of the counters. One of the more strong heroes so far is Doctor Strange. Doctor Strange comes with the protection aspect, so I think these three are really good for solo players to get right at the start or soon after getting the big boxes. I have found that aggression aspect doesn't work that well in true solo, but it is playable, don't get me wrong, but playing leadership, justice or protection is much more easier or playable as a true solo player. Then after these three heroes, I would start buying the other hero packs. There are three other hero packs so far. There is Miss Marvel. Miss Marvel comes with the protection aspect. Then there is Thor. Thor is maybe one of the harder solo heroes to play. There is a lot of gripe about Thor's hand size, which will hinder your play a lot when playing through solo. And Thor comes with the aggression aspect. So that is also why I don't like Thor as a true solo player that much. And finally, there is Hulk. Hulk is like Thor, a really hard true solo hero to play with. I think Thor and Hulk were designed more as multiplayer heroes, and they are really fun to play with when you have a teammate that can keep the, for example, the threat in check, and you can build up your engine, and after that you can just start wrecking the villain with Hulk or Thor. So definitely, if you are playing also multiplayer, grab these heroes whenever, but for true solo I would get the other heroes that have been released so far first. You can start buying the scenario packs after you have picked up a couple of new heroes. I would start as a true solo player from the Green Goblin scenario pack. It again offers two new scenarios, so you get two new villains to play against, both of them being Green Goblin, but there is Norman Osborn, and then there is pure Green Goblin to play against. The Norman Osborn scenario, the Risky Business, is maybe one of the weaker and easier scenarios that have been released, but it's still a fun scenario to play and a good scenario to maybe introduce new players into the game if you are planning to corrupt your friends to play Marvel Champions. So think of buying the Green Goblin somewhere in between getting all of the hero packs and after you have bought a couple of them. The next scenario pack I would recommend for a true solo player is the Once and Future Kang. That was quite recently released. It is a really good scenario. It is a bit more difficult than some of the other scenarios on standard, and definitely on expert mode it is quite a challenge. I feel that the scenario was designed mostly for multiplayer because of one of the mechanic in the scenario, but it's still a lot of fun playing on true solo, so definitely pick this up. The last product so far released that I would buy maybe as the last thing to buy before anything new comes out is the Wrecking Crew. The Wrecking Crew scenario is quite different than anything else in the game so far. It offers a scenario where you are playing against four villains at the same time. The idea behind the scenario is quite ambitious and different and interesting, but the scenario in itself is not really interesting when playing true solo. You are basically just whack-a-moling the villains, and because they have so little health on true solo, they are beaten quite fast, and the scenario doesn't offer that much interesting gameplay, at least for me. I think on multiplayer this scenario is a bit better, but still it's not that good of a scenario on its own. So that is my buyer's guide for true solo players. Hope you found some good tips for which products you should get first if you are just starting Marvel Champions. As always, thanks for watching, and until next time.